Let's take a look at the new Holdout Easing feature in LumaFusion by creating these transitions. Hi, this is ManantialVE. Holdout, or Hold to Next, introduced as part of the Enhanced Keyframe in LumaFusion 5, holds the value of a keyframe until the next one. This creates an instant change without any gradual transition. Here's a simple animation without holdout. And now, with holdout applied. Before we dive into the tutorial, notice that I'm using a 30 frames per second project. Let's start by creating a 2 second size growth animation. Place one keyframe at the beginning with a size of 0.1 and another at the end with a size of 100. Next, add a keyframe every 3 frames. Now, set the ease out of each keyframe to hold out, moving through them one by one. This is done by selecting a keyframe and moving the green ease slider all the way to the left. This is how it looks now. As you can see, the rate of growth is linear, without any acceleration. Let's adjust the animation so the video starts growing quickly and then slows down as it nears the end. Essentially, easing out fast and easing in slow. The challenge is that the keyframes are already set and it's not possible to maintain a consistent rate of acceleration with easing across multiple keyframes. So, we'll have to fake it. Using a copy of the original clip, create another 2 second growth animation. Place one keyframe at the beginning with a size of 0.1 and another at the end with a size of 100. This time, adjust the easing between the two keyframes so the animation eases out quickly and eases in slowly. Place this second clip above the clip with the keyframe holdouts. The second clip containing the ease growth will be used as a reference to set the size values in the clip with the keyframe holdouts. Lower its opacity and give it a tint so it's easy to identify. Now, take the values from the easing clip at the points where the holdout clip has keyframes and apply those values to the holdout clip. This is how it looks when the process is completed. You can now save the animation as a motion preset and use it as a custom transition. Here's how the animation looks as a transition. You can modify the animation in several ways, for example, by adding a slight eased rotation to the growth. Here's how this workflow looks when applied to crop. And here it is with the telescope effect. So this is it for this episode. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel, give it a like, and click on the bell so you're notified when I post new videos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.